we're talking about Evita. It is on stage right now. The Barn Players, that's Martway. Lamar, did you say Lamar?
Martway and Lamar in Mission.
In Mission, and it's been around for 56 years that this group of community talents have come together. And this time around, Evita is the play. It goes till March 20th. Vida Bikales is here. And you, now what does a president of a theater do? That sounds like a pretty hoity-toity job.
I have the opportunity to oversee everything. We have an artistic director who takes care of the artsy
right.
part and dealing with the productions themselves. But somebody needs to oversee the facilities as well as fundraising
right.
and helping to choose the season, helping to choose the directors.
Let's talk about choosing the season, because Evita is right now.
Yes.
But then I notice here at the top it says announcing the cast of Frost Nixon, which is a great, great play and movie.
Yes.
There's a situation where you better have two actors in particular who can really go toe-to-toe and carry their weight and do it. I mean, how do you choose the plays? How do you look at the vast number of things you could do and say, we're going to do Evita and then we're going to do Frost Nixon? How do you choose it?
It's a great question. We have a play selection committee that meets in the spring.
Right.
And then they come up with a list of all of their preferences for what they consider a good, solid season. And they take things into consideration, not just the relevance of the production itself,
right.
but what type of opportunities there are for the actors and musicians that come to our theater, whether it's done a lot locally, whether it's a large cast or a small cast. We try to involve as many people as we can, so we prefer the larger casts. And also it helps fill the house.
Sure, because everybody's grandma and grandpa
absolutely.
And mom and dad and
absolutely.
Kids. Absolutely.
Right. But we look at the relevance and what other theaters in the area might be doing it. We try to pick newer shows, but balance it with familiar names.
So what's coming up after Frost Nixon?
Well, actually, in between
Evita and Frost Nixon.
Right. We have Shout, the mod musical, which will be great fun.
Absolutely.
And then after Frost Nixon is Marvin's Room. And then during the summer, we have our Barn Junior production for our youngest thespians. They're ages 8 through 12. It's going to be Disney's Aristocat Kids, and we're partnering with Wayside.
You have a large litter box in the back for them.
Ooh.
Just in
Hopefully
case.
Not speaking about the type of production.
No.
Good.
Tell me about why people should be involved in community theater. I know folks who have abilities and talents, and they have nice voices, or they can deliver a line, but to convince them to devote the time to it, and also there's a fear factor, too.
Absolutely.
It's one thing to do it in your living room just for a couple of friends, but to get on that stage, how many people are in this theater, can sit in this theater?
We can house 150 audience members.
So if you have 150 people and you do three shows and you've got almost 500 people over the course of a weekend looking at you,
mm-hmm.
that's why get involved in community theater as a participant? Why do that?
Number one, as I'd already alluded to, this is love of the craft.
Right.
Some of these people have done theater all their lives. Some are brand new to it and they've been told that they have nice stage presence or they can carry a tune and they just want to test their chops, and this is a wonderful opportunity for them to do it mm-hmm. and just see if it's something that's of interest. We have some people who've gotten involved at the barn because their child was involved in Barn Junior.
Uh-huh.
And it just looked like it was so much fun, then they kind of dragged the parent along.
Let me ask you a question, since you're the president of the thing, and
yes.
you're a hotshot, and handle the business side of things. What do you say to people who, in these very tough budgetary times for states and municipalities, and they say, you know what, it's neat to have a theater, but and not that I don't know what your funding is like for this, but that people say, oh, we can't put money there, we can't use money for that. Why is theater important to a society and to a culture?
Theater is very important because it's a mirror of the times. It's a release. It's, relatively speaking, cheap entertainment as well. And especially when times are tough, people need to get away and get outside of themselves. And it's a form of communication. So it really serves many different different functions.
And so you would say, your argument would be that the investment, you get back much more.
Absolutely.
Whatever investment there is.
You're learning about history, you're learning music, you're learning just presentation skills. You are, especially for our youngest kids that we are working with,
right.
with Barn Jr., it's a wonderful opportunity to learn about team concept and the pride of performance.
And so, just the fun of it all, too.
Absolutely.
All right, so again, thebarnplayers.org,
yes.
the place to learn more. Avita is the play on stage right now. It's there through March 20th. Vida Bikales, your name almost sounds like it should be a character in this thing.
Why, yes.
You know, you could be Avita's henchwoman, Vida Bikales over in the corner. You don't want to sing?
I really don't.
Don't cry.
And you don't want me to either.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Go see the play, The Barn Players. It's a tradition, and you'll love being a part of it.